coded, going through the whole story, writing notes. And then we begin to compose together. I might write a few pages, you might write a few pages, and then we'd swap it with each other, make corrections, and then meet again online through Zoom and talk it out again and make more corrections. And it's a very laborious process, but at the same time, it's fascinating. Because, you know, I brought in my role as a historian and as a journalist, and Andy really brought in his role as this amazing filmmaker who really had a sense of creating characters and really creating a sense of fast pacing and moving the story along. And often I would kind of want to deepen a certain area, give it more kind of historical context, more cultural context, and then Andy would be pushing us along to really keep the pace going, make it truly a page turner, which is what a thriller is. It was a fascinating project to collaborate together.
You're writing about a global crisis. You're writing about political elements and social elements that in some ways seem to be what you anticipated, maybe unconsciously anticipated, some of the situations that we now find ourselves in as the book is being published. So how long then did this collaboration take?
Well, we've literally been working on it for over 5 years, and both as a film project and as a novel. And it's true, a lot of the book is jumping out of the headlines right now. In our book, we actually have a clashing election, and there's a African-American woman who becomes a presidential candidate and eventually wins the election. And of course, that's something we totally didn't anticipate. We're surprised to see last month with the role of Kamala Harris. It also talks a lot about the use of weapons in the arms race. And so very much part of our novel deals with what's happening today in the world in terms of the development of sophisticated weapons like laser weapons, like hypersonic missiles, which now are being employed both in the Middle East and unfortunately in Russia's war in Ukraine. A lot of these things are coming together. You know, Mark, 30 years ago, the New York Times said Andrew Davis was a master at blending art and action to ask provocative questions about nuclear war and nuclear weapons. And 20 years ago, the Times then said, hey, his film Holes is not just for children, but it's an allegory about greed and social division. I think in many respects, the thriller that we're presenting this month brings those issues together in a very relevant way, really, that's not just off the headlines, but it's really issues that we're going to be grappling with for many years now.
In launching this new book, you're coming back here to Tucson and other places in Arizona to share some readings and meet some of your readers. Tell us what it meant to you.
You know, I have always kicked off every book tour in Tucson. Thank you.
apologies. You watching, nigga, hit us up. Bitch ass nigga. Might as well not wear it too much. I hate when I have to talk to you. Kind of. I'm not sure. I don't feel shit. I don't got shit to do for this, so I might as well do something cool. I think. Actually, no, fuck that shit. It was funny. I've been getting bored with fucking watching YouTube videos. That's funny. And then I might start doing other shit. But shit ain't ever going up, probably. Just gonna be for myself to watch. Well, I'm fucking dead. Well, all the shit. I haven't had any ideas of what.